air tremble. My Lord, reign and let the air tremble. My God, reign and let the air tremble. The Lord, reign and let the air tremble. I said Jehovah is the one big God, nobody holy but someone. So be a biggie for the small God, a biggie wellu wellu, a biggie wellu wellu, wellu 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 wellu. My Lord reign and let the earth tremble.
Thank you. You may be seated. Thank you, Lord. Emmanuel, is God with us? Is God with you? Glory be to God. Hallelujah. We have seen the name Jesus walking in the Spirit. We have seen the value of the name. We have seen the value of staying in faith. Glory be to God. Watch us again. You have seen the name, the value of the name Jesus. For some time, maybe many of us, we don't know the name Jesus. We call the name Jesus just as we call the name of person. But since morning, you have seen the value of the name so much, and the value of staying in faith. Hallelujah. Congratulations. I'm in the midst of successful people. I'm in the midst of joyful people. I'm in the midst of healed people, delivered people, blessed people. I know you would like to hear that. Wow. When the Holy Spirit speaks, changes are beginning. Whether you like it or not, changes are beginning. I want to say to you, you will not remain and you will not go the same. Because we see standing on his word and his assurance of salvation. Take note of that. Because we're still standing on his word. His word say, let there be light. Let there be healed. That is the promise of his word. Are you sick? Let the sick come. We are still standing on his word and his assurance of what? Assurance of salvation. Hallelujah. So I was listening to the testimony. That's it. So all this happened last week. That was last Sunday. And today again. Glory be to God. Let us rise up on our feet. I believe this prayer will lead us to operation. I say, this prayer will lead us to operation. You know, the Lord has given us so much capacity to learn from our mistakes. I repeat again. I mean, Jesus has given so much capacity to learn from our mistake, to learn from our error. That is why you are here today. If there is no capacity to learn from your error, you will not be here today. There are some error you committed that will have led to death. Many error you committed in the past that will have led to what? By now they will have been pointed to your graveyard. Many that are in the graveyard, they have never done so much you have done. Many, some friends, many you know, that when you think back, many that are in the graveyard today, many of them have not committed the error, the mistake you have committed. But today they are pointed to their graveyard. Their dream crash. Because there is so much capacity. These are the testimony, these are the joy, testimony you are supposed to be given. So much capacity to learn from our mistake, from our error, and move on. That is why you are here. You are able to learn from your mistake. That is why you are here. You are able to learn from your error. That is why you are here. If you have not learned from your error, if there were no capacity for you yesterday, you will not see today. You have done so much that will have led to graveyards, that will have led to death or sick beds. But here you are. So God has given us so much capacity to learn from our error, from our mistake. So you bow down your head now. Ask God to give you enough grace to learn from your error, from your mistake, and move on. Mistake will come. You will learn and not fail and move on. Bow down your head, ask God to give you enough grace to continue to learn from your error, from your mistake, ask God grace, Lord, he has given you, but it can still increase that capacity. It can still. There is no limit to the grace of God. What you have today can be increased, can be multiplied. That is why you are here. Ask God, grace, Lord. Grace. Grace. Enough grace to learn from my error, to learn from my mistake. In Jesus Christ's name, we pray. Amen. Viewers all over the world, you know, when we are talking here, we are talking to you. You know, you should know this. I don't need to call viewers. I don't need to mention viewers. When I'm here for all. Mistake will come. So far you are still living. Flesh. And you will learn and move on. So each time that mistake comes, it is not the mistake that matter. What you learn from it. That why should buy this mistake? Why this mistake? No, never you say that next. When it comes, test. You cannot say, I mean, to your level today, you can count how many tests, examinations you have gone through. Each time you need promotion, you should be ready for examination. After passing the examination, you'll be promoted. Promotion cannot come without examination, test, trial. So mistake will come. So don't bother yourself. Why this mistake? Why this error? Why? Oh my God! Oh, I'm a Christian. Why all this? Why all this? No. It will come. What if God allows it? If the tempter have consulted God, allow me to test this man. And the God say, go ahead. What will you do about that? There's nothing you can do. If God allow it, what will you do? So issue of why all this? Why this? I faith this individual. Why all this? Oh my God, I'm a Christian. Don't let that affect your faith. It is time to apply your faith. Time to apply your faith, not to bother. Mistake will come, tell your neighbor. Error will come. You will learn and move on. There's capacity. There's ability. He say, he promised, he never promised to keep you away. He never promised to keep you away from mistake. He never promised to keep you away from mistake because he has given you capacity. He has given you grace. No mistake, no grace. He never promised to keep you away from all this nonsense, challenges, temptation, whatever. He never promised to keep you away. But he promised to see you through. If go must be go, if God must be go, if you must be Christian, tell your neighbor, if go must be go, if you must be Christian, you have to answer that. Tell your neighbor again, if gold must be gold, if you must be Christian, you need to answer that question. What take gold to be gold is what take you to be Christian. If gold must be gold, it must pass through furnace. If you must be Christian, you must pass through temptation, trials. Tell your neighbor once again, if God must be God, if you must be a Christian, so can you see the problem you have? Those things that you laugh, smile when it comes. Promotion is coming. Why this trouble? Promotion is coming. And get ready to pass through it. You are now complaining. If you later come to your office, get ready to be promoted to GM. You must also be ready to go through some tests to see whether you'll be qualified to be GM. If God must be God, it must pass through furnace. If you must be a Christian, a faithful Christian, you must also be passed through. Your character must be tested through resuscitation. Your test may be different from my test. Your may be sickness. Mr. B may be hardship. Mr. C may be accusation. Mr. D may be affliction. E may be limitation in progress. There are some message you don't need to sit down and receive. It's not all the message you must sit down to receive. There are many messages you must have to stand and receive it. That is why you are standing. I'm not telling you about Elijah. History is not history. You must stand to receive this message. I need your body, your soul, your spirit attention. Take this. What takes gold to be gold also takes you to be a true believer. So when all this comes, there's capacity. Inch move you, or backward or forward. Each challenge is that move you forward or backward. You have listened to the testimony of people today. These are the people that were here yesterday, not only Nigeria, all over the world. Instantly they receive challenges they have been having for many years. When the Holy Spirit speaks, changes are beginning. That is Holy Spirit. A man has ability to speak. Take note of that. Man has ability to speak, but Holy Spirit speaks. And when he speaks, changes are beginning. You must identify who speaks to you. A man will walk towards you and speak to you. And a man also will walk towards you and Holy Spirit will speak to you through him. Who is speaking? Man has ability to do what? To speak. Man will say, be delivered. Which is quite different. And Holy Spirit also speaks, be delivered, which is quite different. Man also will say his own. This is why we say, yeah. Anyone can say Jesus is Lord, but not everyone can say it genuinely. Anyone can say Jesus, be healed in the name of Jesus. Anyone can say that. Be delivered in the name of Jesus. Anybody can say that. Be blessed in the name of Jesus. Anyone can say, rise up and pray. Be healed. Be delivered. Anybody can do that. If I give you a mic now, you start saying it. If I say, okay, come on. You'll be also, you start healing, praying. To make a change, you must stand on his way. You must stand on his word and in the assurance of salvation, because it must, by salvation, you can be healed. Because that salvation will help you to maintain the healing. If you receive without salvation, you cannot maintain it. As you receive it, it's gone. By his salvation, you are healed. You can be healed by salvation. Nothing go for nothing, nothing come by chance. Salvation, have healing. Salvation, have blessing. Salvation, have breakthrough. You may be seated. Thank you. Don't just forget the message you received last Tuesday, Sunday, that you have a role to play. The prayer is not just one-sided. Jesus pray, you say, you also ask. You say, amen. You say, amen. As you are sitting, continue to meditate. Your meditation bring results. What is the meditation? In your heart, you see Jesus. In your heart, you walk with Jesus. With your heart, you see Jesus. With your heart, you walk with him. You agree with him with your heart. And you must take control of your heart, because our heart is just like this. Just like this. As you are sitting down, if you don't take hold of your heart, as I'm talking now, your heart will be telling you, who is this man now? Who is this man? Look at him. Look at the way. Look at him. Look at him. And you can't take hold. That is why you must take hold. Just, no, arrest your heart. Are you with me? Are you with me? If you can't, if you don't quick take hold, it's not too late now as I'm talking to you. My heart. Let it look where you look. Right? Begin to take more of me, give me more of you. Begin to engage your heart. If you don't engage your heart as you are looking at me, you will be looking one direction and your heart will be saying nonsense. I don't know this much to answer. This place is too warm. It's too warm. I've been sitting since morning now. It's just come out now. Look at the crowd. How many people would this man lay hand on? This is what your heart will be saying, which is not in agreement with where you are here. Will this man attend to everybody? I don't think he will touch me. Look at, he's going to that direction. Look at him. He's that direction again. Instead of coming to our direction. And you will not talk, but your heart will be busy talking nonsense. I see it, I consider it as nonsense. Mass prayer. Without touching me, mass prayer, how would I get here? Don't forget that the very chronic aquatic boy was healed through mass prayer. And your case is not like that. It's not even up to that level of the boy that was healed through mass prayer. So if such a guy can just be arrested during the mass prayer and everybody rises up and says, and the word of God brought the boy out of the crowd. So definitely you don't have such a serious case. But your heart is such a person that when you greet a person, good morning, sir, your heart will say, see him, very proud man. I say, good morning. He refused to answer me. You will greet, your heart will not greet. So we Christians, we take hold of our heart. Where we go, what we say, your heart, so in order to have what? Accomplishment, result. What you say? You say, be he. Your heart must also release that word. Not you say it, your heart release it. So as you are looking at me now, Begin to meditate in your heart. Don't allow your heart to be silent. Because we Christians, we are not walk by sight. We walk by what? Huh? Do you know what the Bible calls faith? What's faith? When you say you walk by faith, you mean you walk by heart. If you are just going by your eyes, you always have an error all the time. But when you walk, you must walk by your heart. The eyes of your heart must lead you. As I'm looking now, I'm not only going by what I'm seeing, but this heart is the one leading me. The heart has heart, has eyes. The Bible says faith is of man's heart, man's faith, man's spirit, amen. Your heart is where faith is, faith, man's heart. Are you with me? Eh? So when you are sitting down, you must also sit by your what? Your heart. Anything that is not from your heart is a sin. Whatever that is does not come from your heart is sin. That is, are you with me? Okay. You must learn to arrest your heart. Go together. Your heart and your mouth must be in accord, must in agreement. If not, we will not be able to place you. With our mouth, we confess. With our heart, we believe. Salvation. With our mouth, we do what? With our heart. Okay, right. This is life you must begin to live. Are you engaged your heart now? Huh? Take more of me, give me more of you. If somebody is even calling you, it must call all of you. You are two nature in one person. You and your divine. Take more of me, give me more of you. This is prayer we anointed for you. You may have your own prayer, no doubt about that, but because of your weakness, the Lord gave us just a word that's easy for you to communicate. Take more of me, give me more of you, Lord. Your faithfulness, your kindness, your purity, your holiness, your faithfulness is simple. Just simple to communicate. Begin to say that, engage your heart. So when you now engage your heart, you begin to have fulfillment, results. Why we are like this? We are like this because our heart, that is our spirit, is saying this, and our eyes is saying this. You are seeing white, and your heart is talking to a different thing. You are greeting me, good morning, sir. And I say, oh, thank you. And your heart at the same time will say, why are you greeting him? You ask yourself, why am I greeting this man? Well, I will greet him as my pastor. That is our heart for you. You want to give, you give me money. Hey, man of God, have this money. And your heart will say, why should you give this man money? But the money is too much. Money, a lot of things. Your heart is always not agree in accord with whatever you do. So arrest your heart. Once you are able to get this, you begin to walk in the land of God, in line with God, in line with God. know I'm talking to you. At the same time, are you not surprised that as I'm talking to you, I'm also at the same time praying? What is the prayer I'm saying? You want to hear? How does it possible for a man to be preaching at the same time praying? Yes, it's possible. Because I have two natures. And fusion. Two persons in one person. It's possible. I'm working, and at the same time, hi, how are you? And at the same time, I'm praying. Until you begin to live this kind of life, you will overcome this world. If not, a situation where you say, 3 p.m., I'm going to pray, you can never overcome this world. Tomorrow I will fast. Fasting is every day. The word fasting is abstaining from unrighteousness. Prayer every day, every minute prayer, 24/7 prayer. Not when you enter the room, you say, oh, I want to pray, I want to fast, I want to pray, I want to fast. These are the areas Satan used to get you. You know when you are not praying, he catch you. Before you pray, he catch you. You know when you pray, he will not be able to catch you. He will make sure he catch you before you go to pray. Are you with me? Are you communicating in the spirit? That is what we call spirit prayer. It must be 24/7 spirit prayer. Like you are looking at me, you must fire on. Ah, it's your answer ring. Somebody call. You pick it. As you are saying hello, you fire prayer under it. What? You control the person over there. Not, hello, I can't hear you. Hello, I didn't hear all your hello, I can't hear you, is on the low. No, there must be being that will also be fire where you say hello. This is why when you see Christian, when they receive a phone call, if a man is a Christian, you know. He just talks because you are not, you are the only person talking. If there is another talk in the spirit, you can't talk. You wait for the one that talk underneath. You are calling me, hello, sir. I say, hello, what do you want? Okay, I'll wait for you. I would never talk like that. I say, hello, I'll pause. You think that I don't hear what you are saying? I'm praying yonder. People say it's an eloquent speech. Hello, Jesus is Lord, Jesus is Lord. Because he's the only person talking. Jesus is Lord, Jesus is Lord. When, at what time you wait for the Holy Spirit to talk? The one that control you. Nobody control you, are the one talking. Amen. You want to display this key. What are the one that give you the where? Why can't you pause? Hear from him and say what he wanted to say. Are you with me? So when you pick a phone answer and there's a call, you just pick it. You say, hello? Oh, hello, sir. I'm ready. I must hear from the one, my controller, what to say. I must hear from my commander, what to say. I must hear from my instructor, what to say. Hello, sir. Hello. I just say, let me greet you. Thank you. At the same time, I'm praying in the spirit. Can you hear me, sir? I hear you quite all right. Those of you that call me all the time, maybe you have the opportunity to speak to me, take note of my way. You think I don't hear you? I hear you. Because I'm not alone. If I'm not alone, I must hear from him who sent me. Okay. Sir, I want to come and see you. Oh, I'll get back to you. Let me look at my table. I have no table. I want to ask God whether you should come or not, and what time you should come. Because the Bible says, in this world, there is tribulation. There will be disappointment. There will be enemy. Pretend to be friend. He said, in this world, love everyone, but trust. Trust God. So, now you are with me. You need to know who is talking. You can't just be absolutely say, this is a man of God. The Bible says, test every spirit. And just sit down and say, it's a man of God that is talking. Amen. Were you there when he was anointed? So you have to be standby and fire on to under it. What is the fire? Take more of me, give more of you. More of you. More of God will reveal who is talking to you. More of God will tell you who is this man that is talking. More of God will reveal to you if the man has something in the pocket or wear something or swallow something. More of God will just be revealed to you. So, this is what I'm seeing. Terrible, terrible. You see vision, you see revelation as you are sitting down. And know the identity of the man that is talking to you. Or, if the Lord does not show you instantly, when you get home, just asleep, you see vision. So can you see the life we live? You cannot continue serving God with physical strength, eloquent speech, your eyes, your mouth. No. You must serve Him with all your heart. So, to serve God with all your heart, are you praying with your heart? Are you praying now? Are you praying even? What must say to God in reply, in prayer, must come from heart. You must know who wants to lay hand on you. When you continue to allow a man, to continue pray for you, you are ridicule God Himself that created you. It's only the anointed one that can lay hand on you, because you need anointing, not a man like you. This is where you must identify whom you are leaning down before, whom you are asking to pray for you, whom you are adore, call the servant of God. You have a role to play. You assess people by the blessing around you can see. Because it's rich, it's famous, it's popular. No. Let me tell you, there are many ministries that just 2-3 membership that are more anointed than big and biggest ministry. It's not by crowd we assess the man of God. Take note of that. A ministry can be 5 in number, just a 5 in number in the church, and the pastor there will be more anointed than the great minister you might have here so far. Many of us are living on past glory. The glory is gone, but the past one, and we have a way of keeping you. Once you come to our house, you hardly will be able to leave our church. We have a way of keeping you, and we have a way of telling you we are still the same. We have a role to play to keep our spiritual growing. We're always looking for big ministry, famous ministers of God, knowing all over the world. These are the places we believe that the anointing is flow. Our strength is not in the membership, the church ministers of God. Church, our strength is not in the membership, the number of members that attending. This, our strength is not there. Our strength is not the money, millions, or fleet of material we have. Our strength is not there. But these are the things you people consider as a strength of ministers of God. These are not strength. So our spiritual life first. If there's any first place we must grow or prosper, it's in our spiritual life. Before I leave you, let me share with you why it's so difficult for us. After you have made a lot of money, you are rich, fleet of car, companies, you have a lot. Yet, you are worried. There's a burden. Why? You have money, you are well educated, you have fleet of material, cars, property, yet you realize that you are not the comfort, you are not free, the burden is so much. Yes, because it's like we are prosper in our financial life, material lives and everything, but in our spiritual life, zero. It's possible you can be zero in your spiritual life and have wealth, property, material. That is why it's possible for satanic children to be very, very rich. And you don't need... But those will become a burden to you. Your money should be a relief. A great relief for your life. When you have money, you should have great relief. So that you can dash out money to solve your problem. But instead of material to be money and wealth to be a relief, it become a burden because your spiritual life is zero. You have money, wealth, so much. You have people. Yet, there's so much burden. Hardly you'll be able to sleep, but you are not sick. You need help of drug tablet to sleep. You cannot sit down any longer alone for 3 to 4 hours. You need to be in the midst of people to be happy. You need just a great joy, joy that created, not joy of the Lord. So people will make you happy. You need to go to party, you need to go to club house, you need to go to occasion, you need to go to medical checkup, you need to go for holiday every week just to be happy. Those holidays, they are not all that necessary, but you just want to be happy. You are looking for happiness. In the process of looking for happiness, you have to go for holidays, this country, that country, oh country, you go for holiday, you go there, you go there, you have many friends, you have friends, you have to invite you to party, you go to their party, they go to your party. You are looking for just joy, because that the one you have is not sustain you. Now, reverse is the case. Our spiritual life, yes. Because this spiritual life is the one that carry everything we have. It carry our money, it carry our property, carry everything, your fame, your popularity, it is the spiritual life that carry them. If something that carry you is very small, you know the weight will be too much for him. The life many of us live is like you as a person carry this. If you carry this, you soon get tired. Your spiritual life is like that. What's your spirit? What carry you is your spiritual life. It's not your money that carry you. It's not your material that carry you. It is not your fame that carry you. It is not your popularity that carry you. Wealth, no. What carry you is your spiritual life. And what you have is so much, too much for spiritual life to carry. So your spiritual life is just That is why life is so difficult for many of us. With your money, with your property, with your mate, you keep asking yourself, I have money, why should I be suffering? I have this, why should I be suffering? I have fame, I have complaints all over the world, why should I be suffering? Yeah, you have to be suffer, because the person that carry you is carrying so much load, property, and is the one that's supposed to be giant, and those things supposed to be. So where are we going? Many a time I keep telling you people what is going on in my life. Look at the ministry. Suddenly 5 branches all over the world. I say, this is a burden. I will not be able to, my spiritual life will not be able to carry so much. The one people I have here, I'm still having a lot with them. Now having head of pastor in one country, another head of pastor in another country, I will soon finish looking for money and my spiritual life will be gone. Until I'm able to have the capacity to have the branch, the ministry will remain here and I will be traveling all over the world to do revival all over the world. You know, ministry, having church is so, it's a big thing. Each head of the minister in heavenly branches is also overseer of himself. Because reverence they give us cannot be ruled out. It's not easy. This is why today, when you look all over the world, many biggest churches I was born, the biggest churches and biggest branches all over the world, I never see them maintain it before they die. It's so difficult for them to maintain those things before passing on to glory. It's always difficult. Trouble come before the end. Clash come. Trouble come. Clash come. It comes like that. It's always since I was born. And the one I read to in the book, those who have precious all over the world, big churches all over, it's always difficult for them to maintain them before they pass on to glory. What I will not be able to maintain, it's better not to have them. You should be able to have what you will be able to maintain. So we are talking of our spiritual life. So I want you to work on that. The challenge you have is simple, like I have said. God has given us a capacity to learn from our challenges. So if you don't want challenges, you don't want to learn. Tell your neighbor, you don't want challenges. You don't want to learn. Tell your neighbor again, you don't want challenges. You don't want to learn. What lesson will you learn from breakthrough? Breakthrough come, it come. What? Pleasures. What lesson will you learn from pleasures? We much learn from challenges. Your challenge could be sickness. Your challenge could be poverty. Your challenge could be limitation in progress. Your challenge could be affliction. Just name it. Your challenge could be temptation. You don't want challenges, you don't want to learn. And you don't want to learn, you don't want to move forward. Capacity to learn from our challenges. Challenges will come and we will learn and move on. You have given challenge a name. You say challenge is from witchcraft. Challenge is from wizard. Whatever place the challenge come from, whether it's a witchcraft or this or that, challenge is challenges. It must come because you need to move on. You need to grow. You know the process of seed growing. When you plant the seed, you water them, you nurture them. Why should you water seed? Because of season, dry season, rain season. You nurture them, you keep them away from the insect bed. You try to remove weed around it. These are the challenges seed have before becoming what? Become what? Before they grow. Before grow and become beneficial to you. In the same day, you are a seed growing So I want to leave you. Your faith is lifted up. Let me see your hand. I would like to ask a question before I leave you, and I want somebody from the heart of people to answer this question. What lesson, how does this message appeal to you? Because somebody. How does the message appeal to you, and what lesson will you learn from this message?
Thank you. Don't rely on yourself, but on the Holy Spirit, because the burden will arrive, challenges will come. If you rely on yourself, you will not hold it, you will not stand it, you will not maintain it. But with the Holy Spirit, you will go forward. You need challenges to move forward, to learn and to move forward.
What are the challenges we are talking about?
Problem of life.
Thank you. Clap for her. Thank you. You listen to that? He said, we need challenges . There are some challenges you cause by yourself. And when you cause a challenge and it comes, God will withdraw his strength for you to face it. This woman now, I decided to give him a dirty slap and beat him up. And I now say God will be with me to settle the matter, to